Saints in Christ, greetings on this fourth Sunday of Easter, also known to us as Good Shepherd Sunday. It is an immense joy to welcome all of you to our time of worship once again that the Anglican Church now invites you to join us as we celebrate our risen Lord and Good Shepherd, who knows each of us by name and nature and loves us all. As this month of May is observed as Child Month, and in our church as Home and Family Life, and in our nation now as we celebrate the parish of St. John, our worship will be led by the youth of Holy Cross Church in St. John, and the preacher will be their new priest in charge, the Reverend Audrey Griffith. They invite us to worship with them under the theme, Called by Name, as our Lord calls us even now to worship Him and to thank Him for the deliverance that He is leading us to, even as we go through this experience of COVID-19. Let us worship Him and celebrate His presence in our lives even now. Amen.
Good morning, my brothers and sisters in Christ. Welcome to our Diocesan service for today, the fourth Sunday of Easter, otherwise known as Good Shepherd Sunday. Traditionally, this is the Sunday we remember those in the ordained ministry, persons in training for ordination, and those considering the sacred ministry as a vocation. Today, as we worship, we lift up before God all our clergy and seminarians who cannot be with us today, as well as those persons in our congregations who are wrestling with the call to the sacred ministry. In our regathering and God's gathering initiative, today marks the beginning of the month where the focus is on the parish of St. John. We are unable to meet and celebrate the life of the parish together, but it's even more important to remember that the Lord has been our people's guide for the last 300 and more years. So as attention is brought to this parish, we hold the divine light over this parish and we light our candles declaring God's presence in our midst to heal and restore this land. Today, the youth of Holy Cross, with assistance from other parishes, will lead us in worship. We pray God's blessing on them as they do so. Let us pray. Almighty God, who calls into being every aspect of creation, we call on your name as we gather in our several places to engage in this act of worship. Help us to remember throughout this time that we are seeking to be together in love, in order that you may be present to be with us in a special way. Be with all those who witness this act of worship, and may they gain some sense of presence and guidance in their lives, now and always. Amen. The choral ministers will now lead us in the call to worship. They will be singing two lovely choruses, Glorious and He Never Failed Me Yet.
Up the name of Jesus, and you hear the music playing.
Oh yes, my Jesus never failed me yet. Let us pray. The Lord is my shepherd. He makes me lie down in green pastures. For you are with me. Your rod and your staff, they comfort me. You anoint my head with oil. My cup overflows. O God, whose Son Jesus is the good shepherd of your people, grant that when we hear his voice, we may know him who calls us each by name and follow where he leads, who, with you and the Holy Spirit, lives and reigns, one God, forever and ever. Amen. The choral ministers will now lead us in an old familiar song. When he calls, I will answer.
From the Word of God, written in the first epistle of Peter, the second chapter, Reading from verse 19 to 25. It is a credit to you if, being aware of God, you endure pain while suffering unjustly. If you endure when you are beaten for doing wrong, what credit is that? But if you endure when you do right and suffer for it, you have God's approval. For to this you have been called, because Christ also suffered for you, leaving you an example, so that you should follow in his steps. He committed no sin, and no deceit was found in his mouth. When he was abused, he did not return abuse. When he suffered, he did not threaten, but he entrusted himself to the one who judges justly. He himself bore our sins in his body on the cross, so that free from sins, we might live for righteousness. By his wounds, you have been healed. For you were going astray like sheep, but now you have returned to the shepherd and guardian of your souls. Here ends the reading.
Written in the Gospel according to John, chapter 10, beginning at the first verse. Jesus said, "Very truly I tell you, anyone who does not enter the sheepfold by the gate, but climbs in by another way, is a thief and a bandit. The one who enters by the gate is the shepherd of the sheep. The gatekeeper opens the gate for him, and the sheep hear his voice. He calls his own sheep by name and leads them out. When he has brought out all of his own, he goes ahead of them, and the sheep follow him because they know his voice. They will not follow a stranger, but they will run from him because they do not know the voice of strangers." Jesus used this figure of speech with them, but they did not understand what he was saying to them. So again Jesus said to them, "Very truly I tell you, I am the gate for the sheep. All who came before me are thieves and bandits, but the sheep did not listen to them. I am the gate. Whoever enters by me will be saved, and will come in and go and find pasture. The thief comes only to steal and kill and destroy. I came that they may have life, and have it abundantly. Word of God.
As we sing the hymn before the sermon, He Knows My Name, I ask you to pay special attention to the words as it links closely with our theme, Called by Name.
He calls his own sheep by name and leads them out. Words from the 10th chapter of the Gospel according to John, verse 3a. Today is the fourth Sunday of Easter, Good Shepherd Sunday, a day when the church reflects on Jesus as the Good Shepherd who laid down his life for the sheep. It is also Vocation Sunday, the day when we are encouraged to discover, to recognize and to reflect on God's call to us. Altogether, today is a good day because Jesus is still the Good Shepherd who knows each one of us and calls us by name. And so, I invite you to pause with me for a few moments as we reflect on the Shepherd, on the call we hear, and on the name we have been called by. Friends, The portrait which the writers of the Gospels have painted of Jesus as the Good Shepherd, whose sheep know his voice, and as the one who laid down his life for the sheep, is not a picture which just randomly emerged from their imaginations. Instead, it is a picture which Jesus clearly planted there when he used it to describe himself in one of his I Am statements found in the Gospel according to John. "I am the Good Shepherd," he said. But did he come up with this portrayal of himself just out of the blue? Where exactly did Jesus come up with this description, which he used to describe himself to his listeners? Friends, the portrayal of God as shepherd was something which had occurred centuries before Jesus walked the dusty roads of Palestine and told his disciples that he was the Good Shepherd. In fact, this portrait of God as shepherd is one which can find its roots in Genesis chapter 48, verse 15, when the patriarch Jacob on his deathbed blessed his son Joseph and said to him that God had been his shepherd all of my life to this day. And it finally flowers in the vision which was given to John as recorded in Revelation chapter 7, verse 17. Where we are told that the saints who have come out of the tribulation are brought before the throne of God, and that the Lamb at the center of the throne will be their shepherd and will guide them to springs of the water of life. And while it is true that the idea of the leader as shepherd was not an idea which was found only in the Bible, the teaching of God as the absolute shepherd of his people was a teaching which was not found in any of the other cultures with which Israel coexisted. It is therefore clear that the people of Israel were very well acquainted with sheep and shepherding from the times of their ancestor Abraham, who was a shepherd, as well as his grandson Jacob, and Moses, their great deliverer. And furthermore, there was also that great shepherd and king whom we know all so well, David, the author of that shepherd psalm, Psalm 23, which is also the psalm appointed for today, a psalm which begins with the words, "The Lord is my shepherd," words in which millions find reassurance. Now, friends, we know that sheep are usually very quiet and gentle animals. And we know from watching them how they sometimes wander around dangerously if there is nothing or no one to restrain them. We also know how they follow the leader's sheep at the front of the flock to wherever that sheep leads, unless redirected by someone or something. Well, just like us, Jesus and his followers knew these things as well, for they would have observed the sheep of their day and the ways in which the shepherds handled them, how they protected the sheep from danger, how they sometimes fought with wild animals in order to save the sheep, how they sometimes fought with thieves, and how sometimes the shepherd even died because of his efforts to care for the sheep he had charge over. Therefore, for Jesus' followers, the portrait of him as the Good Shepherd was one which they could easily understand and accept, because it was real to them. Friends, it follows that if Jesus is the shepherd, the Good Shepherd, then we, the church, his church, we must be his flock of sheep. So that in the same way it was for the shepherds of Palestine, it is with Jesus. For as our shepherd, he leads us. As our shepherd, he protects us from danger and seeks us out when we go wandering off. As our shepherd, he fights for us as he did for Peter in Luke chapter 22, verses 31 and 32a, when he told Peter that Satan had demanded to sift all of you like wheat, but I have prayed for you that your own faith may not fail. And as our shepherd, he too laid down his life for us. So even though we are all out of our comfort zone right now because of events beyond our control, We must not forget that he has promised that the gates of hell would not prevail against his church, even though it is prone to danger from both outside and inside. Friends, the writer tells us that our shepherd calls us by name and leads us. Now, it is a known fact that animals can recognize the voices of their owners, and sheep are no exception to this. So we too must be able to recognize our shepherd's voice when he calls. But what is the call of the good shepherd? Or in other words, how does he call his sheep? Since the writer tells us that he knows us and that he calls us by name. I believe that the call of the good shepherd is the call of love, the sound of love, for God is love. I believe that the good shepherd calls us to follow, to obey, and to enter the abundant life. We are not driven like cattle or horses or terrorized into love, but we are instead invited and led gently by the good shepherd into love. And I believe that whenever we respond to love and respond in love, to love in any language, that it is the voice of the good shepherd we would have heard and are obeying. For it is the good shepherd alone who leads us out in love. For whenever we do right by our sisters and our brothers, we demonstrate that we are indeed his sheep who are being led by his love. So that even now in the midst of these serious problems in our world, when so many lives are being cut short and are being negatively impacted by COVID-19, by crime, by conflict, or by harmful weather patterns, we are still called to love, to help, to assist wherever we can. Because God's call is a call to love. God's call is a call to serve. God's call is a call to obey. Now, I don't know about you, but I find it somewhat humorous that in chapter 4 of the Gospel according to Matthew, that Jesus the Good Shepherd called his first two disciples as he walked beside the Sea of Galilee. He did not go into the hills or the pastures where the sheep grazed to call shepherds, but instead he walked by the seashore to call fishermen. Of course, this is not to say that the call did not or does not go out to shepherds, since the call indeed goes out to all of us. And it is also true that on the night of Jesus' birth, the shepherds of the field had a starring role. But it suggests to me that we should never attempt to put God in a box. For when Jesus asked Peter if he loved him, those three times in an apparent response to Peter's three denials, he also told this feisty fisherman to feed his lambs. But that is just the workings of a quirky mind. Follow me, Jesus said to them, and I will make you fish for people. And as Stephen Curtis Chapman puts it in his song, for the sake of the call, they abandon it all for no other reason at all but the sake of the call, wholly devoted to live and to die for the sake of the call. Friends, this song about some seemingly crazy fishermen who abandon their nets at the water's edge and agree to follow wherever Jesus led them because he had called them by name just about sums up what it means for us to hear our names being called by the voice of love. We leave everything and follow. How many of us have left comfortable careers to follow our passion of looking out for the poor or the elderly? How many of us have been called to be a nurse or a teacher, even though we wanted to be an accountant? How many of us are wrestling with a call to the ordained ministry? There's a story retold by Wayne Muller in his book, How Then Shall We Live, of a tribe in Africa where before a baby is even conceived, the mother goes off by herself and listens for the child's song. After she receives this song, then she goes about conceiving the child while singing this song. The same song is afterwards taught to the others in the village, so that it can be sung to the child in the womb, sung during his delivery, sung as he grows, sung when he does bad things, and sung when he does good things. It is sung when he marries, and finally at his death, it is sung for the last time. What is our song? What is our name? Friends, we all have a name, the same name, child of God, beloved, friend, made in the image of God. Are we comfortable wearing that name? Are we living up to that name? Do we hear it as we grow and as we live and as we fall and get up again? Are we listening to our shepherd's voice? Are we hearing our name? Friends, he knows your name. He knows my name. And he calls us by name. For to paraphrase Blaise Pascal, there's a God-shaped vacuum in the heart of each human being which cannot be satisfied by anything or anyone other than God, the Creator. Now, I told you at the beginning that today is a good day. No matter what dark clouds are swirling around us right now, as we face the risks and deal with the terrible and far-reaching effects of this pandemic, today is still a good day. Today is a good day to give thanks. Today is a good day to pick up the telephone and call that neighbor or family member you cannot get to see because of the lockdown and social distancing. Today is a good day to pack a bag of groceries, however small, so that we can drop it off on the step of someone in need when next we are out on our assigned business day. Today is a good day. A good day to stop and pray for our nation, and indeed, to pray for our world. Today is a good day, my friends. A good day to stop and look for the silver linings, to listen for our shepherd's voice, to listen for his call. Today is also a good day to answer him. Indeed, today is a good day to answer the call of love. For he calls his own sheep by name and he leads them out. Amen. Let us with confidence and hope confess the faith into which we were baptized as we say the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord. He was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen.
Let us pray. Eternal God, the doors are closed to the places we worship. May our hearts be open wider to sing your praises and glorify you in our lives, even more in this time of separation. O Holy God, who hears the prayers of your children, hear our humble prayer this day. You sent your Son into the world to help us to learn more about who you are. In his life, by his actions, he showed us that you are love and reminded us of our need to love God with all our heart, mind, soul, and strength. O loving God, who loves each one and calls us daily into being, hear our humble prayer this day. We confess that we have not sought at all times to serve you in loving and serving others. We have at times been self-centered and have not considered the needs of others. We beg your forgiveness. O gracious God, who welcomes us home and loves us still, hear our humble prayer this day. We pray today for all those persons in service of the Church, especially those who have offered themselves to the ordained ministry, to be shepherds of the people of God. Grant to them the willingness to serve as Jesus served, to be faithful shepherds. Great Shepherd of us, all help our pastors to be as you've been, faithful, loving, and caring. Hear our humble prayer this day. Be with those this day who are experiencing your call. Give them courage to respond as Samuel did and accept your purpose for their lives. May they be assured of our prayerful support and love as they take this step in their lives. Loving Shepherd, you teach us all to trust you and your will for our lives. Hear our humble prayer this day. Many of us today are experiencing the effects of being shut away. Even with all the tools and gadgets that we have become addicted to, they pale as we desire human interaction and contact with others beyond our own households. May we remember this time and realize how important it is to treasure the friendships we have and the ability to embrace. In your word, you called the little ones to you and you took them up into your arms and blessed them. Loving Shepherd, grant that we may know the depth of the human embrace and treasure it as we move beyond this time. Hear our humble prayer this day. We give thanks this day for all those who are currently at work assisting in protecting, caring for, and serving others in the midst of this pandemic. We pray that they may be protected from the effects of the virus themselves, and that they and their families may remain safe from any harm. O Giver of life, who keeps your servants safe and protects them on every side, hear our humble prayer this day. For those who are sick at this time, especially those who are in hospital or quarantine, or are without the constant presence of their loved ones, send them comfort in the person of those who care for them and those who are with them in similar conditions. May they recognize your hand in those who come to them to bring them comfort. Sovereign Lord, who knows the hearts of each one of us and who comforts us, hear our humble prayer this day. For those who during this time have had to lay to rest loved ones, whose grief was made greater because they could not feel the presence of those who love and support them in their grief, grant them your comfort and keep them until they can receive the human touch from those who care. Compassionate Lord, who comes in mercy and comforts those who mourn, hear our humble prayer this day. Grant, O God, to those who have died in faith, your divine presence and eternal rest. May your perpetual light shine upon them. And now, as our Savior has taught us, so we pray. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come. Your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. And forgive us our sins as we forgive those who sin against us. Save us from the time of trial and deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen.
Brothers and sisters, wherever you are, the peace of the Lord be always with you. Now to him who is able to do immeasurably more than all we can ask or conceive, by the power which is at work among us, to him be the glory in the church and in Christ Jesus throughout all ages. The Lord be with you. Let us bless the Lord. Friends, we are so delighted that we could have shared this act of worship with you from the Church of the Holy Cross. We thank all those who assisted in making this service all that it has been, and for the wonderful opportunity to make this contribution to our world at this time. We pray that God may keep us faithful and trusting, and that the day may soon come when once again we can be together in person. We now invite you to listen to our final song, Blessed Be the Name of the Lord.
Blessed be the name of the Lord. on.